इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स इज नथिंग बट ए सिस्टम, एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सिस्टम विच कैन ट्रांसमिट इट्स इंफॉर्मेशन और ए डेटा टू द इंटरनेट. सो दैट इज वॉट इट हैज बीन कॉल्ड एज इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स, राइट. सो अगेन, so what could be the internet of things in deep and how we can design internet of things and what are the protocols, what are the things involved in this, let us know again now in this session. So as we said, like, this is what the textbook we have to prefer, and these are the future. So what if you can say what are the things, sir, so that I can say, starting from my shoe, means my shoe can say how much distance I have traveled today and what was my speed when I was traveling. From there, my home appliances like light, fan, I can control, I can monitor wherever I could be. And coming towards the industrial things, many industrial things and cars and automobiles, even in defense and medical areas, all these are things. All these things are connected to internet. That is what we will be calling it as an IoT. So fine. This IoT has a definition. As these are the course objectives, what we discussed yesterday. These five units were discussed with different topics in the IoT. And this is our syllabus. So in this, we'll be discussing definition, characteristics, and physical design of IoT today. So yesterday, this is what introduction or history of IoT, where it was started in 1982 and made into a particular IoT development in 1999. RFID community has developed into one particular community actually here. These are few features of IoT. And coming towards the definition, the Internet of Things is a network of physical objects, right? So yesterday even we have discussed this definition. Internet of Things is a network of physical objects. So what could be the physical objects? It could be a device as an instrument. It could be a vehicle. It could be a building or anything else. It could be any sort of embedded or an electronic circuit within. So this is what the IoT about. Now, the other way of defining this, IoT, the second point, the IoT refers to internet connection via internet of computing device embedded in everyday objects enabled to send the data. So data is nothing but information. So which was embedded within it and connected to the internet, right? So this is what explains in the second way of definition. And this is the other way of defining the IoT, where you can see here the statement was made in such a way that this definition has the characteristics of IoT. Let me say, guys. So let me say, if you are trying to know something, you will be trying to know the character of that particular. If even the person, if you want to communicate, if you want to get interacted with that person, you will be trying to know the character of that person. Right. So if you are well known with the character of that person, yeah, you will be having a good interaction, good communication with that person, even if you go with any particular product or any particular thing. So now this definition was designed in such a way, here itself, the characteristics of that IoT was mentioned. That is what? A dynamic global network. That is what the character of an IoT. A dynamic global infrastructure with self-configurable capability. It should be configured by itself based on the standards and interoperable communication protocol. It should have the communication protocol even where a physical and virtual things have the identity, because each and everything should have an identity, physical attributes, and use the intelligent interface and are seamlessly integrated to the information network, because surely it should be connected. Integration in sense, it should be connected to the network. That communication data with the user and environment. It could be a user or any such particular environment. So this is what the way, general way of definition. The other way of definition, where it we can see it in the books, actually. So this is what the overall definition here. You can see as mentioned. Now we'll be knowing the characteristics of IoT. So guys, what we have learned in the previous definition, the same points we are going to learn here. Fine. So here it was mentioned again, like all the characteristics what we have designed. Yeah. So we have total 5 characteristics. Out of first one is dynamic and self-adaptable. Dynamic and self-adaptable in the sense, like, if you designed an IoT device or a system, let me say IoT device, so that should be ready to adapt the environment dynamically. Because let me say environment monitoring device I have designed. So today it will be very rainy. Tomorrow it will be more hot, and day after tomorrow it will be very cool. So depending upon the environmental changes, the device should be ready to give any sort of information what the environment is trying to give us, right? At the same time, it should be adapting the environment where it will be, right? So it should be ready to face the all context where user is trying to, right? So this is what dynamic change and self-adaptable. So the IoT device and the system, I can call IoT device or a system, maybe have the capability to dynamically adapt with the change of context. So the context here, it means like it can be a context where the environment is trying to give or where the user is trying to give. In some cases, as the application changes, so the environment is trying to change dynamically. So the IoT device has to change. And it should be adapted to that situation, where in some cases user is trying to give some instructions to the IoT device. Depending upon that, the IoT device has to adapt to that dynamically. So those could be the two different conditions: user context or sensed environment. Next one, characteristic is self-configuring. So here, self-configuring is there is a situation is all about, like, it should have the it should be ready with the what sort of configuration it should be. Because, like, in some cases, if I can say the IoT device has given some sort of some another peripheral has connected. So by that, what happens here, like some other device has been connected, it means like it will be configuring with that device and it will be going to execute. In some cases, the device may change. At that situation, what happens? It should be get it configured with that event. So that capacity should be there within the configuration of the device. So most probably in weather monitoring situation, sometimes to that device, maybe different sensors are getting connected, and it should be ready to getting connected with all such devices, right? Now, characteristics of IoT, the remaining characteristics: interoperable communication protocol. So this is what we have listed in definition. Actually, let me give an example. Maybe it was like, right now I am not sure, but I have been with my friend where his mobile is Apple iPhone and my mobile is general Android mobile, which could be Redmi or Samsung or like. So mine is Redmi. So even the Samsung and Nokia is also the same feature. So when I just want to transmit my data to the iPhone with share it, it is not making much possible. So these two different mobiles are trying to getting connected to transfer the data. Then what we preferred is Bluetooth protocol. So guys, sharing is one sort of protocol. Bluetooth is another protocol. So we should be ready. That particular device should be ready to getting communicated with any other device protocol. So it should be not restricted to only one particular protocol. right? So the system should be ready to getting communicated with any particular protocol. Fine. So that has to be done here. So now, in the same way, the other capacity is unique identity. So surely, guys, when you are creating an IoT device, it could be any sort of sensor, and which it could be anything else, and you are trying to transmit that data. So that particular device should have some particular ID number, identity. Even you are going to be, we are going to identify you with your roll number. The same way, each and every IoT device. As I said, we have billions of IoT devices in the real-time world. So each and every IoT device are having its own unique identity number. So that is what the next action. The other one, it is integrated into the information network. So that is what internet, right? So each and every IoT device should be integrated, should be connected to the network, internet, and getting try to transmit the information and getting try to communicate with the device. So this is what happens here in this characteristics of IoT. So these are the few characteristics of IoT devices, and these are the few more additional characteristics. In this diagram, you can see few self-configuring. We have learned dynamic environment, unique identity, connectivity. So these things we have learned, heterogeneity. Few things like sensing is another characteristic. Should be ready to sense each and everything. Intelligence should be very intelligent enough that it can go through any action depending upon the situation, and it should be more large. We have many large scale devices, means it should be embedded in the large scale. I can say like car. Actually, right now cars, I can say before that cars are totally mechanical, slowly it was embedded. Now in a car, I can say more than 50 to 60% car is running with electronic components. I can say it is an embedded, right? 50 to 60% of car is embedded in electronic components are ruling the electronic devices are ruling the car over there, right? So this is about the characteristics of IoT. Now, physical design of IoT. So what is there in IoT? What blocks are considered? So it is generally things in IoT and IoT protocol. What you can see, those are things in IoT. And what is their background to the IoT, that is the protocol of IoT. Now, the things in IoT is all about like, it is referred, means what could be things, means a thing, it has unique identity and it can be ready to sense, or it can be ready to monitor, or it can be ready to have the capabilities of sensing or activating all things. This particular characteristic we will be calling it as a thing. So this IoT can exchange the data, or it can only transmit the data, or it can only take the data. All this can be happen with the help of some sort of server or a cloud, right? So based on some application backend, it can be run. Some sort of software is required, some sort of programming is required to build some such particular server or a cloud here, and then that will be used to build the IoT device, right? So this is about the things in IoT. Now, a general block diagram, what the IoT can be considered. So this is what the block diagram of IoT you can see here, where the middle one, I can say the pink one, the processor. In IoT, the core of the IoT is nothing but core of the IoT, or an core of an embedded system. Guys, embedded system is not exactly different from IoT. I'll be calling an embedded system because actually we design the projects by adding few hardware components and writing some code in that, electronic hardware components, writing some instructions in that, that makes the embedded system. What makes IoT here, because when this embedded system is transmitting the data or getting communicated with the help of some cloud or with the help of some internet server, that is called IoT. So I can say, if you want to design an IoT device, surely some embedded system has to be involved in that. So that is the reason I'll be calling, I'll be taking the word embedded system. So this is what the embedded system I can call, where the IoT system, IoT device consisting of. In this, the processor CPU is main core part, right? It is going to have the microcontroller or a processor or a microprocessor, anything else like mainly microprocessor or microcontroller in this processor. This is much more important or main core part. The secondary what we required is memory interface and storage interface, RAM and ROM. Where memory interface is called as RAM, it may be built with the help of NAND or gate or DDR1, DDR2 dynamic RAMs. And the other one is storage, ROM, what we call is SD or MMC or something else. So these are the secondary important part in our designing devices, embedded or IoT device. And next, we need some sort of connectivity. It could be an USB host or Ethernet. Some sort of connectivity is required to so that I can transmit the data into the internet, right? Into the cloud or into the server. So that we'll be trying to use this connectivity. And the third one, the fourth one what we'll need is I/O interfaces. Surely I can say I can prefer this as third one and connectivity as fourth one. Yeah. So in this IoT interfaces, here it was mentioned few protocols, UART, SPI and I2C. These three protocols you have already gone through in previous subject like microprocessor and microcontroller. CAN is another type of protocol we have. Actually, apart from this, I/O interfaces means you can see in the bracket, like it can be considered as some sort of sensors, activators, and etc. Right? So it has some sensors, activators, and the few more peripherals in this. So joining your microcontroller, adding RAM and ROM, and then some sort of peripheral sensors and activator, and you are connecting to the internet. That makes an IoT device. Apart from this, we have few more blocks here, audio and video interface and graphic cards. Yeah, depending upon the requirement of your device, how you are designing, these two are going to be involved. So there may be a situation like if you are going to use some mobile, there you need audio and video interface. And if you are going with some gaming device, yeah, surely some particular graphic cards are required. So here, these two are additional use, of course, depending upon the situation, how your IoT device is designed, there you can know. So guys, this is about the general block diagram of IoT device. Fine. So now fine, let me know, the next topic is IoT protocol. Guys, I just want to discuss this IoT protocol. Before this IoT protocol, we start discussing, before we start discussing this IoT protocol, let me know, like already we have discussed the definition and characteristics of IoT and some things of IoT, block diagram of IoT, I can say. Do you have any doubts here? Or are you okay with this? And may know the CR of ECA section, I think, Manideep. Are you there, Manideep? ECA and ECC, I'm not sure about ECC, who is the CR? So guys, before I start discussing the protocols, I just want to go through an IoT project, whatever I have done. Few IoT projects. But I just want to explain one of the IoT projects so that you'll be getting idea. So directly we'll be trying to know these protocols and all the servers and all. Maybe we feel some complication over there. So I just want to explain why this IoT protocol. Mute yourself, everyone. That is the reason, because we were somewhat addicted to Zoom, so we were not ready to go with the other particular things. So anyway, I just want to know